Hey, it's Allison, and today I'm going to help you troubleshoot any pesky issues you may face with automations. Whether an automation fails to execute, or you notice it has been disabled in the automation center, there are several ways to get your automations up and running again. Let's say you have a great idea for how to save your team precious time. You add the automation to your board, and oops, it doesn't work. Or you get a banner telling you that your automation has failed, though thankfully, why? Let's scope out the most common reasons your automations may fail and set yourself up for future success. If you created an automation on a board that is no longer running, the first thing you should do is make sure you still have access to the board and therefore the automation. In the admin settings, make sure the user type is set to member or admin. If it has been changed to guest or viewer, the permissions will not allow for the automation to run. Speaking of permissions, make sure viewing and editing is enabled in the board settings. If granting access to that user is not an option, you can transfer ownership of the automation to another user. Pretty cool, right? If you recently reactivated your account, your automations will still be deactivated. Luckily, this is an easy fix. Simply click the switch, and you will enable the automation to run on your board again. Let's use this automation as an example. We can see that the trigger is a specific column, with the action being one that takes place on two boards. Now, if the column were to be deleted, there is no longer a way for the automation to be triggered. Same goes for the board of origin, destination board, or even an entire workspace being deleted or archived. With nowhere for the item to go, the automation will be unable to run. So be sure to recover the missing trigger or target, or recreate the automation with active elements. This is a super common issue, and you'll be surprised how easy it is to fix. Let's take our same example. You want a completed campaign to move to the campaign archive board, but let's say you also want to see the campaign in the completed group on the board of origin. Since both of these actions require the same trigger, we can't have multiple actions in play without them competing. The solution? Combine these two automations into one. Just add additional actions, and you can accomplish exactly what your heart desires. Each board has an item limit, with the limit depending on the tier of your account. If you have reached your account's limit, any automations that result in the creation of a new item will be deactivated. To fix this, delete or archive some items from the board, and then reactivate the automation in the automation center. And there you have it. As always, if you find you're still having trouble making your workflows work best for you, check out our help center or reach out for personalized support. If you're looking to learn how best to automate your workflow, click here or click our logo for more ways to get the most out of monday.com.